A new twist tonight in the fight over a quarry in Westbrook. It's owned by Pike Industries, and the company wants to expand. But neighboring businesses like IDEX Laboratories oppose the move. A special task force has been working on a compromise, and tonight the plan went before City Council. News 8's Jackie Kucher tells us what they decided to do in our top story.
Tracy, a question that's been there all along is whether or not Pike has the legal right to operate the quarry. That decision is still being worked out in court. For now, though, the city council is trying to focus on the area's future using recommendations from that steering committee that was put together by the mayor. Now, the council gave initial approval to rezone the five-star industrial park area to industrial manufacturing. Basically, it would prohibit any future heavy industrial activities at the park, including quarrying. Pike Industries, however, would be grandfathered in if they end up having the legal right to operate their quarry. Members of the Westbrook Works support the rezoning as they believe a judge will determine that Pike doesn't have the right to operate it. Pike says they're optimistic they and the neighbors will be able to compromise outside of court to keep everybody working.
Our members are unanimous in support of the rezoning that has been proposed.
Blasting, explosions of any duration are incompatible with a mixed-use urban area.
If no consent order is reached and the rezoning is all that we're left with, then it's a problem for Pike. But we still have hope that progress can be made and that some sort of compromise can be reached.
Now, the quarry compromise steering committee made a strong recommendation that the major players sit down and work it out. Of course, the major players are Pike, the city, IDEX Laboratories, and members, of course, of Westbrook Works. If people want to comment on the rezoning of the area, there will be another public hearing on June 7th, and the city council will make a final decision after that, and we'll be following it. In the studio, Jackie Kucher, News 8.